Hey guys, it's Dylan, and in today's video I want to talk about drift and some of the driftiest charts in the game. Now before we get into the charts, I want to kind of explain what drift is, because I think it's another one of those words that gets kind of thrown around in the Beatstar community as kind of this word to describe any chart someone struggles on as kind of an excuse. But there is a reason behind drift, and I'm going to kind of explain that right now. So in my opinion, there are four different types of drift, and I'm going to explain each one of them right now. The first type is general drift. And you'll see this in pretty much any rock song, and there's a reason. General drift happens because a song's BPM changes by micro, like kind of small intervals throughout the song. So a song might have a BPM of, let's just say 140, but for some parts of the song, it might be 141 or 139. And the reason this happens is because humans are not perfect and cannot play drums or a guitar at a perfect BPM for the entirety of a song. It just simply is impossible. We are not that precise. We are not as precise as machines. And therefore, with some of those older rock songs, like No One Knows, you just can't keep a tempo. Nowadays, obviously, we have technology, so a lot of the rock songs and metal songs that happen today use kind of an electronic timing system so that they don't play offbeat. And so that's why some of the newer stuff does not drift. But older rock songs, especially like 90s and pre-90s stuff, is just a mess. So that's general drift. Next type is vocal drift. Now, vocal drift occurs when an artist sings or raps off of the beat. Now, this is particularly eminent in songs like Thrift Shop or Miss Jackson, because those songs, you can clearly hear the rapper rapping off the beat. So, like in Thrift Shop, a lot of people say Thrift Shop drifts. Well, I don't know if I would go as far as to use the term drift. It's more of Macklemore just decided he wanted to be cool and rap off the beat slightly. He has a kind of a style to his rapping where it's not always completely on beat. He kind of adds a little bit of character to it. Miss Jackson's just a mess. I don't even know what Miss Jackson is, but Miss Jackson is all over off the beat. But vocal drift basically is just when an artist raps or sings off of the beat slightly. Another way that you can notice this is in certain rap songs, and a rap artist will rap slightly faster than the beat. So when you're playing the tiles, it kind of feels like they're dragging because the rapper is kind of speeding up their vocal pace beyond the BPM of the song, which is kind of weird because they have a backbeat, so you'd figure they would be able to keep on, but sometimes an artist gets carried away. The next type is bad cut drift, and basically this occurs when the people at Space Abe, which, by the way, props to them, they make some really good song cuts, but sometimes they don't. Sometimes they make a bad cut, and this can be especially seen in songs like Get Ready 2013. There's a really awful cut around stage 3 that makes like a part of it really, really late for no reason. You know, it's just stuff like that. So sometimes there's a slightly bad cut, and it causes drift. The last kind of drift is a charting mistake. Now, I've only got one example right now on my mind. I'm sure there's others, but the one that really comes to mind is Enemy. Enemy doesn't necessarily drift. It definitely doesn't drift in any of the Imagine Dragon parts, but Jid's part, the beginning of Jid's part, it just has this weird drift to it where the same pattern is played over and over again, but it gets slightly later and later each time you play it, to the point where it's not even remotely synced with the song. And this is kind of a bizarre one because this is purely just a charting mistake on Space Ape's end, but yeah, it's just kind of an anomaly. All right. Now let's get into my top 5 list of most driftiest song/charts in Beatstar. Now keep in mind these are in no particular order except for the number 1 spot, because I've pretty much certainly determined that it is the worst case of drift in the entire game. And it's obvious, I think it's a song from the 70s, don't quote me on that. But it's an old one, and it makes sense why it drifts. So, let's get into this with number 5, which is already on screen, Don't Look Back Into the Sun. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to do a test I like to call the play the game how it's supposed to be played, but still get a bad score test, because that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to play the chart to the audio of the song with my sync set up correctly, and you will see how the chart may go slightly off, and I might pick up some perfects, even though the taps sound like they're on point. So, let's get into it. Now, for this test, I'm only going to play the first 3 stages of the song, just in order to save some time here, because we have 5 ones to go through. But here we go. Mm-hmm. All right, so I lied there. I played the first four stages, because the first four actually went by really quickly. So I think I might do that for all the songs here. But as you saw, it wasn't super drifty in the beginning, but as you got into the chorus, it definitely got much driftier, and then that whatever that mess was before final was the worst part by far. But anyways, let's get into our number four spot. At number four, to probably no one's surprise, we have No One Knows, one of the worst cases of drift in this game. And it's very obvious within the first three stages that you're going to be experiencing it, but stage four is where it really nails in the drift and it gets pretty unbearable. So let's get into it. Here we go. It may not be apparent on screen as I'm getting all perfect pluses here, but what I can feel is the notes growing farther and closer. So this is a bit embarrassing. I'm not exactly sure how I didn't receive more perfects there, but I can promise you it felt a lot worse on screen, and I'm not really sure, I don't know, that boggled me right there. Honestly, I thought I'd pick up more perfects there. Maybe I'll have to move that on the list, although, like I said, the top four aren't really in any particular order. Number one is pretty guaranteed, though, and you'll really see it with number one when I get into that. So without further ado, let's move into our third place. And third, we have Fell in Love with a Girl, or Philwag for short. One of the worst cases of drift in this game by far. This one is awful. There are some parts that go so late, it's not even funny. Now, actually, before I start this one, I will explain the concept of late versus early drift. When a song drifts late, it means that the notes are farther back when the song plays. So let's say the word girl is played, and there's a note for the word girl. I'm actually going to turn this down a little bit so I can explain this. If there is a word, let's say the word girl plays, and there's a note that's supposed to be here, so you tap when it says girl. If the note is here when they say girl, that means the chart is drifting late. The note is later than the song. Now, if the note is already here when they finally say girl, then the chart is early. It's too soon. It's coming too soon. So that's the concept of late versus early drift, and drift oftentimes includes both of those. When a song is drifty, it usually goes early and late. This is kind of BPM fluctuation. It's just something that does happen. So, let's go ahead and play this. Here we are. We'll be right back. And I'm going to pause here because I didn't even realize I had entered final stage, but I knew that the most driftiest part you saw there with the My Heart Must Be Beating, those double notes, super late. I just wanted to make sure those were on camera, so sorry I actually sneaked into the final stage there, but it just gets so bad. It just gets so bad, and it only gets worse towards the end. Just figured I'd show you guys that. So let's get into our number two place now. Here we have Rabbit's Foot. This one is rather notorious for its drift problems, and honestly, it's just a mess. It goes super late in certain sections and then super early, and it just doesn't make sense. And there's a really awful drum roll section towards the end, just feels disgusting to play. It's got all kinds of problems, so let's just get into it. Alright, here goes Rabbit's Foot. As you can see, that one just kind of gets progressively better, and it does. This song progressively gets less drifty, but it is super drifty from intro to stage 3 about. It cleans itself up a little bit in stage 4, but it's not much better, and then final stage, it's okay, but it's still not great. But yeah, Rabbit's Foot, just really not a good situation. But here goes the number one spot. And here we have Oh, that's curious. I just noticed. If you listen, the part that's playing right now on the deluxe autoplay is not part that's in the deluxe cut. What I was going to say is My Sharona Deluxe, the number one worst and most driftiest chart in the game. And I'm not talking about the standard. The standard actually has mild drift compared to what this one has. It is just all around an awful experience and gets way off the rails too quickly. So let's get into it. So for this one, I've decided I'm going to play all the way through it. There might be an extra camera shake because there's a lot of doubles here, so I apologize if the camera gets a little bit violent here, but this one is just bad. So here we go. This right here is the single most driftiest thing I've ever seen in my life. it goes almost a whole note off of the beat, which is just embarrassingly bad. And you'll see it really bad here. This part's actually surprisingly on. That's not. Yeah, a 98,000 is not a particularly good look for a song played completely on audio. That was 75 perfects. Because of how drifty My Sharona Deluxe's was. And it is bad. So, yeah. That is your number one most driftiest chart slash song in the game. Now, before I end the video here, I do want to give some honorable mentions because there are tons of drifty songs and charts in the game. And I only wanted to name five in this video in particular as the worst ones. But there are tons of drifty songs. So here is the honorable mentions. Tornado of Souls, Winona's Big Brown Beaver, You Really Got Me, Debaser, Duality, Figure It Out, More Than a Feeling, Sweet Home Alabama, The Motherlode, The Trooper, and more. Because there is more that I didn't list here that obviously didn't make the list. I didn't list any vocally drifting charts or bad cut ones or charting mistakes. I already gave examples for bad cut and charting mistake, which those are really the only of their kind. But I didn't list any of the vocal drift ones other than, you know, like Thrift Shop and Miss Jackson, but there are other examples as well, like Raiden, Chameleonaire's part oftentimes drifts and it feels kind of awkward. But yeah, that's about it. Hopefully you guys got a better understanding for drift and got some knowledge out of this video. That's all I want to give you guys. Again, please put some feedback in the comment section. I really do want those video ideas because I want to give you guys the videos you want to see. And also, yeah, drop a like, leave a subscribe if you want to, hit the bell, get the notifications. I'll see you in the next one.